Iceland is now one of the countries with the best legal rights for LGBT individuals. I am proud to say that during my time as Prime Minister, we passed a law for same-sex marriage, and on the day this new law took effect, Jónína and I changed our civil partnership into marriage. Our love survived all the obstacles that needed to be overcome, and later this month, on the 27th of June, we will celebrate our 6-year wedding anniversary. But our joy is mixed with sadness. It is difficult to enjoy a life of freedom and tolerance while so many of our brothers and sisters in other countries have to fear for their lives every single day. And one can ask, what is their crime? It is simply to love someone who happens to be of the same sex. Prejudice and ignorance are the main obstacles to sensible discourse about queer issues. That is completely intolerable in a world of ever-growing knowledge. Not to mention the pain of living all your life contrary to your true self. It is vitally important that every human being freedom and human rights are respected all over the world. No one should have to endure oppression, abuse, or lack of freedom, or even forfeit their life for claiming the fundamental human right of living in accord with their feelings. In many countries around the globe, this human right is not respected. Often by self-appointed leaders who think they alone know right from wrong. Leaders who reign in the name of some kind of orthodoxy or because of an enormous greed for wealth and power. Leaders who stop at nothing to make others accept their undemocratic stance, not caring an iota about human lives, health and happiness. Human rights organizations around the world have indeed made the world a better place. They have challenged extremist elements that far too often and far too wildly, cruelly deny queer people their basic human rights. It is terrible that in the year 2060, there are around 80 countries in the world that have some kind of anti-gay laws. And in some of these places, these laws are ruthlessly enforced. It is terrible that in some countries it is legal to send queer people to prison for the rest of their lives, sentence them to hard labor, whip them, or send them into exile. It is terrible that in up to 10 countries it is a capital offense to be gay, and that there are laws that sentence queer people to death by public stoning. The fight for queer human rights concerns each and every society in the world, just as the fight for gender equal rights. It is not a local issue, but a global issue. But even full legal rights are not enough, as we saw in the extremely tragic event in Orlando, Florida, a few days ago. Only education, open and honest discussions, and love can encourage understanding and dispel hatred. The fight for queer equal rights is not over until the whole world understands that the feelings of gays, lesbians, bisexual and transgender people are exactly the same as the feelings of heterosexual. Love is simply love.